Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Today we're going to be doing a quick video review of Dungeons and Bombs. Now this is a indie game that came out on the Xbox Store on the 26th of February 2021. It's published and developed by Pigeon Dev, and they've kindly provided us a copy for this review. It's basically sort of a 2D puzzle game in the vein of sort of... Bomberman, where you move and you drop the bombs and you move out of the way to obviously blow up tiles and stuff like that. I'll quickly read the blurb for it. So, Dungeons and Bombs, dynamic fusion of classic sokoban puzzles and Bomberman-inspired games. When enemies drag people into the dark lair, into their dark lair, and they do their vile deeds there, the hero and his faithful sword always comes to the rescue. But what if the hero does not have a sword, but a lot of enthusiasm and an endless supply of explosives? Well, bad for them. Go through dark labyrinths and dungeons and try not to blast yourself up. 1,000 years ago, there was a flourished kingdom in the lands that was already called the Ancient. And so the idyll would have continued. I'm not 100% sure what that means. If not the Unholy Union. It's a bit broken English there, unfortunately. Under its shadow, tribes of orcs from wildlands, necromancers, and undead from chilly crypts, as well as apostate knights from the outskirts of the kingdom, and they decided to kidnap the beacon of the whole kingdom, its princess, who in all the surrounding lands was famous for her beauty and her beard. So yeah, in this game, the princess you're trying to rescue has a beard. I'm not sure why. It doesn't ever explain it, but hey. It's indie game, what do you expect? So it says, under cover of night, they stole her from her own bedroom and hid her in the ancient catacombs under the castle. Few would dare to descend under these gloomy vaults, but only one hero was needed to save the princess. A kleptomaniac and a pyromaniac with an unhealthy craving for explosions, but still the most devoted knight at court. He was sent by the king to find his daughter. Will a brave knight be able to save the princess, or is he destined to perish in the darkness among enemies? I mean, that sounds like some sort of like epic RPG sort of plotline. But basically, it's a puzzle game. You've got turns, and you've got every movement or every use of a bomb takes up a turn, and you have to get to the princess at the end of each level to progress. There's 50 levels. So it says there's 50 entangled puzzle levels, unbreakable laws of logic, explosions and bombs in capital letters. So yeah, I mean, I've quite enjoyed this. It's one of the smaller games, like indie games. It's bloody hard. I mean, I could only get to sort of like level 20 before starting to use a guide, because some of them are just so mind-boggling. I just couldn't get any further. And I have no shame in saying that. But I mean, if you like a good puzzler and you're into these sort of like moving and using up turns sort of systems, then it'll definitely be your cup of tea. But it's funny. It looks cool. If you're an achievement hunter, you're looking at about an hour for completion. If you just literally follow a guide, probably looking at a couple of hours if you just try and figure it out yourself, maybe two or three. But yeah, I definitely recommend it. I mean, as you can see, the gameplay's on the screen. It's dead simple. You only use A to drop the bomb, and the left and right sort of, and up and down on the directional pads for the movement. Obviously, if you step on sort of spikes or enemies touch you, then that removes one of your moves as well. So you have to sort of work your way around without being touched and without getting hit by things and using your bombs to sort of blow up boxes and stuff like that to make your way around before sort of your turns run out. But yeah, it's currently available on Xbox, PlayStation, Switch, and it currently costs £4.19 on the Xbox Store. So and it's Xbox One X enhanced as well, according to the listing. So it's not an expensive game. It's great for achievement hunters. I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10 for what it is. Like I say, I'd give it more, but honestly, it's not my cup of tea, and I couldn't get around some of the levels without, like I say, without a guide. So definitely check it out if you're into sort of puzzle games. And if not, keep an eye out for more reviews on the channel soon. So if you can give us a like and subscribe, that'd be great to help us build the channel. And we'll have more review videos coming soon.